She's a sacred cow. There is no cheaper mistress, but you'll pay anyhow. And is it really like a feeling made electric? Is it really like a fire inside your soul? Or are you only waiting for a single moment?
You're listening to FromeFM 96.6. This is Soundcheck. My name is Sara Vian.
I am John Ford.
And today in the studio we have got Hodmadoddery. Hello.
Hiya.
Hello.
How are you?
Good to be here.
Yeah, where have you come from?
I came from Bath today.
Yeah.
But I came to Frome first. I had a meeting in
Frome. Mm-hmm. So you both come from
Bath? I
don't
know where Frome is.
Yeah.
No, I come from Bristol.
Bristol?
Yeah.
So the southwest.
Yeah.
Cool. So, brilliant. You're basically going to play us a few live songs, and then we're going to talk about your influences, and then feed out with a few live songs at the end. So thanks so much.
Sounds good.
The first song that I've got listed here is a song called Spanish Bride. Is that right? Can you just tell us a quick...
It's a song by an English songwriter called John Tams, who's a songwriter and actor. And at the very beginning and the very end, there's part of a very old song, very old traditional song, but most of the clever stuff in between is him. And it's about, the Napoleonic Wars in Spain. Because you've got to have songs about old wars, because it's folk music.
Mm-hmm. Great. Okay, great. Thanks.
Wars, do that thing.
Brought me a daughter to my heart.
Lord Wellington's army. War being over, it's homeward we're bound. There on the quayside, weeping and wailing, 4,000 women left on that cold ground. Farewell and adieu to you, Spanish lady. Farewell and adieu to you, ladies of Spain. We've received orders, sail home to England. Have a know, sometime we'll return once again. And if ever I return, it's with gold and great plans. Ever I return, it's with gold and great store. And I search far and wide, my Spanish lady brought me such peace in the midst of such war. Farewell and adieu to you, Spanish lady. Farewell and adieu to you, ladies of Spain. We've received orders to sail home to England. And I know sometime we'll return once again. Farewell and adieu to you, Spanish lady. Farewell and adieu to you, ladies of Spain. We've received orders to sail home to England. And I know in some time we'll return once again.
FromeFM 96.6 Soundcheck with Sara Vian
and John Ford.
And I just want to introduce you all to John, because John does a show on FromeFM called The Rambling House, which is essentially sort of folk. Is that right, John?
Yeah, it's folk traditional music, but basically a rambling house where people come in and talk about what they want to talk about and play what they want to play.
Well, we were kind of hoping that you would have a sort of knowledge of folk, which is kind of why we brought you onto the show, in a place of Patrick, who was out there moving his canal boat down to Banbury. So big shout out to Patrick. So that last song, where did that come from?
Well, I can say it's about the Napoleon
Wars. Where's that mic, Stu? Was that talking mic thing?
Yeah. Sorry, I'm trying to tune as well.
Oh, bless you.
Multitasking. Sorry. I'm not really set up for multitasking.
Oh.
You said it's the Napoleonic Wars. It's in those days. You see, when you had an army, you didn't just have an army. You had all the camp followers. You had people that depended on. People that depended on the army for their existence, also people whom the army depended on. It was, I mean, okay, you know, supply trains and all that kind of thing, but it was really complicated in those days.
Mm.
And so that's a story about a soldier falling in love with a Spanish woman, living together with her on the campaign, and then when they all got ordered back to Britain, England, then they had to leave them behind. That's that.
Yes, and many, many thousand of them, apparently. They all got dumped on the, as it said, dumped on the quayside.
Yeah.
Which is really tragic, really. I mean,
there's a lot of songs and tunes that come from that era.
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
You have Mary and the Soldier as well. Where
she
wanted to dress up as a man so she could go to the war so they wouldn't be apart from each other.
where do you find your songs?
Oh, blimey, all over the place. I don't think it's anywhere in particular. It's just.
Can you remember the first song that you played together?
Oh, Lord, what was that?
Wasn't Geordie then?
I don't think it was Geordie, no. I think it
was. When we met, there were a couple of singers that we really liked. There was Dick Gocken and there was Christy Moore, both of whom we've already mentioned. And I think we probably tried one of those.
Possibly. There wasn't a lot we could we were capable of.
Well, it was just
Song for Ireland we used to play, yeah, didn't we?
And how long ago did you meet?
Blimey, it's sort of just after the mid 1980s, I think it must have been.
Mm-hmm.
So I was in India in 1984 and then lived in Bath. I must have moved to Bath about early 1985, so it must have happened sometime after that.
Something dreadful. Yeah, yes. About 30 years ago, anyway.
Yeah, and can you remember where it was?
Not exactly. I mean, we had sort of friends in common around. There was a street in Bath called Park Street, and there was a kind of social scene centred around that street.
Was there a good folk scene in Bath at the time?
I don't remember. Not enormous. I mean,
there was a
folk club, wasn't there?
There was a folk club that I went to and saw stuff, but no, we didn't play there. Our first gig was in a notorious cider house called the Beehive. Pie, yeah. Where they used to pay us in cider, and we were allowed to take a collection, and they paid us in cider, which was good enough for us.
Yeah, sounds good.
Fantastic. So you've been playing together for 25 plus years.
Something like that. Yes, yes.
And do you play quite regularly, or?
We're on about a gig a month, I think. I would wish it was a little more often than that, but a gig a month, you can just about stay in trim, and it means the rest of doesn't get that much in the way of the rest of your life, I suppose.
Hmm.
But if we even playing once a month for the last 30 years, that's quite a lot of time.
Yeah.
And then we do concentrated periods when we play quite a lot.
Mm-hmm. Like festivals and stuff.
Yeah, festivals and stuff.
So if actually, have we haven't properly introduced your names, have we? You've got like fabulous names, haven't you? Can you tell us your full name?
Oh my God. Anthony James Magnus Carter.
Fantastic. Yes.
Magnus, great. Magnus Carter. Great. That's nice.
In fact, Magnus was my mother's maiden name, so that's where that
was
comes
it?
From.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Well, that'd be Magna, though, wouldn't it?
No, there was a Danish branch of the family somewhere. So that's
it, does it mean magnificent?
It means great, I think, in Latin, but why it was given to me, I don't know, but there you go.
You deserved it.
And what's your name?
I'm Steve Henwood. Easy for short. Henwood is a village in Cornwall. It's the nearest village to the Hurler's Stone Circle on Bodmin Moor. So it's deeply mystic, don't
Good
you know?
Celtic lads.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you could talk about the next song, Geordie, while Steve tunes up, would that work?
Could do that. We'll try. Yeah. Go on.
I can try.
You can try and talk about it.
God, it's one of those old songs. There must be hundreds of different versions of it, both musically and lyrically.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember why we started playing. I think Steve gave me a recording of somebody. There was a couple of people playing it, and I thought, oh yeah, that sounds all right. We can probably just about scrape our way through that. And it came from that's a long time ago. We've been playing it for almost since we started. So it's
do you know much about the history of Geordie, John?
No, I don't.
It's the story of going back to when the king owned vast parks full of deer, and this guy went into the park, obviously he was a very poor man, and hunted the deer, which was punishable by death, and got caught, and that's what happens, he gets hanged for it. It were tough in them days.
Mm-hmm. And it was, and it's from the green cassette, it's from our very
first. The very first cassette we did, it's on that, which is, yeah, it's 1,000 years ago.
So it's still available?
Oh, God, no. I don't think I've got a copy of it.
Because they're still releasing cassettes, aren't they, in the sort of right on vintage world?
Yeah. I've had some demos from very, very hip people indeed on cassettes, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Possibly because they're confident that you can't listen to them.
Exclusive.
Yeah.
Cool. So, yeah, I mean, do you want to play Geordie for
us?
Let's play
Geordie.
I walked over London Bridge, misty morning early, overheard a fair pretty maid was lamenting for her Geordie. The Geordie'll be hanged in a golden chain, it's not the fate of many. He was born of a king's royal breed, and loved a virtuous lady. Bridle me, my milk-white steed, bridle me, my pony. I will ride to London's court, plead for the life. Geordie never stole no cow nor calf, never hurted any.
He stole 16 of the king's royal deer, and he sold them in Bohedi.
Two pretty babes I've had by him, the third lies in my body. Freely part from them, everyone, if you spare the life of Geordie. Judge looked over his left shoulder, says, fair maid, I'm sorry. Says, fair maid, you must be gone, for I cannot pardon Geordie. Geordie will be hung by golden chain, not the chain of many. Stole 16 of the king's royal deer, and he sold them in Bohemi.
Geordie.
let the note ring forever.
Yeah. Right, so we're going on to another song. Tom Tiddler's Ground.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Do you know the origin of this song?
Well, it's a Roy Harper song. Tom Tiddler's Ground, as far as I read it, it's a kids' game, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
I think it's a chase game, a catch game, and I think you're all right if you're in Tom Tiddler's Ground. I think that's like.
But they used to stand up in a pile of rocks, and.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And then it kind of changed into the game of tag.
Well, there you go.
Yeah. Yeah, if you were.
And it's one of the things I like about Harper is he drops kind of odd bits of English legend, mythology, but commonplace stuff, you know, not your highfalutin heroics, but kids game is brilliant. So.
Yeah they say then if you're unsure about something, you're on Tom Tiddler's Ground.
You know? That's the one. Well, you know more about it than I do. Then that's cool.
I'm going to use that.
Should we play it then?
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
Please, yeah.
Thought I had passed, but you caught me at last. Where you knew what I could never be one. And now that you're here, and you finally do hear, well, it's so clear on the wings of the dawn. My starts to shine as you breathe in the brine, or the spray of the very same day, same day we all go, for sure we know what it is to be floating away. Oh, there's a lot. Tom Tiddler's Ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's Ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's Ground. Long before Eden was lost and found. Now you have to be kind if you're ever gonna find that place where your face should have shone.
especially when you don't care to force anyone there to share. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Long before Eden was a lost and found.
And you heard me say yes, but you know it's a guess. Someone else shouted no. Oh, 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 oh.
You know freedom is free, all the forces to be, and the ice that you do thought you should throw. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, there's a love. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Long before Eden was a lost and found.
There's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground. Oh, there's a loveliness on Tom Tiddler's ground.
You're listening to FromeFM 96.6. This is Soundcheck with Sara Vian.
And John Ford.
And in the studio tonight we have Hodmadoddery. And it's just so harmonic. It's just beautiful. I love seeing big, strong men being beautiful. I feel we should rewrite the fairy tale. And, you know, instead of having knights going to war, they get, you know, instruments and paintbrushes out.
I'll send the women out.
No, what? No.
They're tougher than men anyway.
They'd get it sorted out quicker.
Yeah.
They'd make less of a mess of it.
They decide there wasn't actually a problem.
Yeah. So that was Tom Tiddler's Ground.
Mm-hmm.
And how old's that one?
Oh, it's a song from the 70s, is it?
74, wasn't it?
Oh,
yes.
Yeah. Well done. It's coming out now. So this is the second third of the show where we kind of talk about your influences.
Mm-hmm.
And your first choice is Commune by Roy Harper, is that right?
Okay. Oh, that's kind of me. I always loved, I was always very, very taken by Roy Harper. I don't think there was anything ever quite like him. He's kind of, I always thought of him as kind of like the English Bob Dylan, but better. It's just something about his lyrics, and I mean, he's a strange guy. Apparently, I mean, he can be very moody, but I don't know. He's written some brilliant songs and some wonderful lyrics. And,
But the lyrics of Commune,
oh, they're fantastic.
Yeah, they are. It's a beautiful
really
song.
Really beautiful. So
but
yeah.
Do you think a mainstream artist would get away with writing words like that nowadays?
Well, I think his son doesn't do a bad job. Actually, Nick Harper's kind of carried on the tradition, I think, in a way. He's different, but he's got the kind of the gift.
He's got the gist, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, should we listen to Commune?
Yep.
Okay, so that's Commune by Roy Harper, and I must admit, you know, I haven't really heard of Roy Harper. That's rubbish, isn't it? Is he really famous?
Yes, in a cult sort of sense, I think.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of people wouldn't have heard of him, perhaps, but
yeah, he's like a hidden backbone, really.
That's a fairy.
It was great mates, not only with Pink Floyd, but with
Zeppelin as
so
well.
Even though he wasn't a huge rock star, he got to
hang out
with and acquire the bad habits of.
Yeah, he was in the song Remains the Same, that movie, where he played the greedy businessman.
They wrote a song, didn't they? The Hats Off to Roy Harper, it's called, I think, on the Led Zeppelin 3.
So he was in the scene.
Cool. So the next one is Erin Go Bra.
Erin Go Bra, yeah.
Erin
well
Go
done,
Bra.
That girl.
By Dick Gochan.
Dick Gochan.
Okay. And
he's called Gochan in Irish, in Ireland, and he's called Gochan in where he's from.
Well, he's half Scots and half Irish, apparently.
Yeah.
But
he
was maintained he was, and I've seen him live. And
Who chose this one?
I did again. In fact, Steve brought it round. He did an album called Handful of Earth, which is where that song comes from. And Steve came round one day and said, "God, you got to listen to this. This is great." And I listened to it and it just knocked me sideways. Mm. Beautiful. And that song, I just thought, wow, I'd love to play like that. I'm still trying. It's a great song.
Yeah, it's a song about the Scottish and the Irish that were...
Yeah, because a lot of the Irish, I think, ran to Scotland to escape the Troubles.
Yeah.
And they didn't always get a good welcome. In fact, to be fair, the same applied to Highlanders going to kind of places like Edinburgh or Glasgow. They didn't get a very good welcome very often.
Yeah. What's they called, Edinburgh and in the song?
Old Reiki.
Yeah.
So they're all quite tough sort of stories, aren't they, these songs?
Yes. I mean, he meets a policeman who gives him gives him some jaw, as he says, and he ends up killing him. So it's quite a heavy song.
Yeah, really. I mean, I think it dates from a bit earlier than the last lot of Troubles. I think it's from an earlier lot of Troubles.
Oh, so it goes back.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure. I mean, my history is pretty vague. But
Okay, shall we have a listen?
Yes.
So can you pronounce that, please?
That was Éireann go Breá by Dick Gahan.
Fab. I really like that. I really like that. Kind of brought up my passion for Geoffrey Tullett, sort of remind me of that a little bit. Yeah, and
he's got such a voice, that guy.
Yeah.
I mean,
such a soul.
Amazing guitar player, but to me the voice touches me in places that
that album is
doesn't
yeah. What's
other
the
music
album?
Doesn't get to
Handful of Earth, it's called. There isn't a bad song on it. It's fantastic.
Nice.
It's really good. Yeah.
Gonna have a look at that.
He played in Bristol about a year or two ago, was it?
Yeah, he's around most years. He plays plays in Bath annually, I think.
Really?
The folk. Well, the remains of the folk club there put him on.
How old is he then?
Sorry, that's not fair. There is a good folk club in Bath.
He must be getting on a bit now.
Has to be. I mean,
I don't know how old he'd be. Pushing 70, I'd guess.
Should we just do a quick shout out to who's listening? There's my friend and co-presenter B Brooke. I think Flounder may be listening. Thierry Leroux, is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah.
In France.
Yeah.
So if you want to say that.
Thierry I did a French exchange with him when I was kind of 13 or something.
Yeah.
Which is quite a long time ago, considering. So he's a great old friend. I'm just really, really pleased he's listening. Ha!
Yeah. So he's
Salut.
Sitting comfortably Bonsoir. In France listening to you live. Isn't that the power of radio? So if anybody else is listening, do post a message on Facebook or Twitter and then we can send you a shout out.
I got a text in also from Anonymous and it says, hello all, I'm listening.
Oh yeah, so if you emailed in to tell us you're listening, if you could let us know who you are and we'll identify you.
Well, if you're the Constable family, which are old friends of mine, you're now living in Ireland, in County Kerry, hello. I will come and visit you one day, honest.
The constables are still after you, is that
so? I expect so, yes.
Maybe they could get you a gig in Kerry and that get you over.
That would
there,
be fun.
It?
Well, last time I went there, they gave me one without telling me, which was a bit of a fright, but no, it was good fun. Yeah.
Stop me getting nervous, was it?
Yeah.
Nice part of the world, Kerry.
Yeah. So, the next song that you've chosen.
What's the next one?
Spencer the Rover by John Martin. Who chose that one?
No, we're not playing it. We're listening to it. The reason I chose this one, it's like the last two songs. In fact, it's got a drop D tuner on it. It's very lovely and droney. And I love things that have a sort of bass that just stays there. Mm. You can kind of float off them in a different way than you can.
It's like meditating.
Something that keeps being fiddly and changing.
Nice and stable.
And stuff. So yeah, and the other thing is I absolutely adore John Martin's phrasing. I mean, he's got a fantastic voice, but as a singer-songwriter, you'll know it's like where you puts the syllables of the words, and John Martin was a real, he played around with that in a
Gonna have a proper listen to that.
And finally, Spencer is a traditional song, so this was a good doing something quite different for the time. Anyway, doing something quite different with traditional music.
Mm-hmm. And what was the time?
The time. This is one that it's early 70s, isn't it?
I think so.
'73 or something like that.
I can't remember what album.
One can blithely say 73, 74 for quite a lot of this.
Early '70s.
Early '70s.
Okay, so let's have a listen to Spencer the Rover by John Martin. You're listening to FromeFM 96.6, and this is Soundcheck with Sara Vienne.
John Ford.
And we've got Hodmadoddery in the studio. So that was John Martin. Was it?
Indeed.
Spencer the Rover. That too. Lovely, heartfelt singing.
Yeah.
Made me wonder if you like James Taylor.
Yeah, but I prefer the trad British stuff.
Yeah.
In fact, we were just talking about places that John Martin lived. When I first encountered him, he lived in Sussex, which is where that song's from. Well, oh, yeah. Or where that song was collected from the Copper family of Rottingdean.
Really?
So
wonderful name, sorry, Rottingdean.
Yeah, Rottingdean. Links up anyway.
We've got some more people watching and listening, haven't we, John?
Yeah, Ida Down is watching on the concert window.
Hello, Ida.
And a shout out to Susie, who's listening in. And hello to everybody who's listening and watching.
Yeah, and if people have got access to the internet, well, obviously, yeah, you could be listening on the radio, couldn't you? If you go to www.concertwindows.com/FromeFM, you can actually see this live.
Which is a bit alarming, if you ask me. But
I know, you are the premier concert window act. So thanks for that.
You should have got someone prettier, I think.
You're looking fine, gents. Yeah. Fine. So, John, I'm going to let you introduce the next track because I keep hogging it all, don't I?
Right, we're talking about influences, and now we've Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. And you've chosen Woodstock. So.
So I chose that because the harmonies are wonderful. And what I like about performing with Tony is the harmony thing. I don't know whether that's come out in what we do.
Yeah, it is.
Done.
That is your strong point, isn't it? Harmony.
But CSN and Y, we're in a... Well, CSN and then with Neil, we're in a completely different world as far as that. As far as that went, they were hitting weird chords and doing things out of the regular meter and all that. They were very clever with it, but it inspired me.
Wasn't it?
Yeah. it inspired me to get into harmony singing, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I mean, the song being Woodstock, being that movie, I thought, looks like these people are having fun. You know?
It's funny actually because Joni Mitchell had a TV interview the day after Woodstock, and she didn't think she would make the interview, so she didn't go to the concert. But Crosby, mm-hmm. Stills, Nash got a helicopter from Woodstock, and they were on the same TV show, and they did it. So she was so disappointed that she actually wrote the song about Woodstock.
She did write it, didn't she?
She did.
Yeah. And the other great thing about this tune, if we get far enough, is it's got a really wild guitar solo on it, and that's one of the things I still like Neil Young for, because he'll absolutely no holds barred with an electric guitar in his hand.
He just said today that on no grounds would they reunite. There were talks about them reuniting again, but he said no. He doesn't want to do it for some reason.
Mm. Anyway, let's have a listen to Woodstock by Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. Right, that was Woodstock by Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. Yeah. Yeah, very cool. They were just there in truth for a small moment there, weren't they?
Absolutely, yeah.
You were saying there about the way they do their harmonies?
The harmonies are fantastic. The phrasing's fantastic. It inspires you to... Oh, you push the envelope. Push the boat, a better expression. Yeah.
Out of the harbour and raise your mast.
That's the one.
Yeah. I just want to...
Other motivational phrases.
Yes. I just wanted to sort of say hello to Pearly McLeod, who's listening in.
Pearly McLeod.
Yeah. Pearly McLeod.
So you don't recognise that name, do you?
I don't.
So if Pearly could let us know who...
She's probably fortunate enough not to know us personally, don't you?
And Morph Flounder.
Morph. Yeah.
Saying fine looking fellas.
Oh my God. Yeah. How much has she had to drink tonight?
it's all that rose coloured lighting.
That's the one, yeah.
Okay, so we better swiftly move on. John, what's the next song?
The next song, when we're speaking about influences, is The Incredible String Band and You Get Brighter.
And the string band sneak in here, one, because I love them, but two, because they're a brilliant example of what you can do with just two with just two people.
Yeah.
And both had strong characters running off in different directions, but and they're magical.
Yeah, there's nothing ever quite like them before or since, I think.
Yeah. This was released on a double album in the UK. But in America, then they separated them and released them as two separate albums.
And this is about, what, 1969 or something? I'd have guessed, but I don't know.
Yeah, it was 69, yeah.
Yeah.
But they actually sold out the Fillmore and the Albert Hall. But their album was 180 in the charts.
And they were and they were at Woodstock too, but they refused to go on in the middle of the night. And if they'd gone on in the middle of the night instead of Melanie, they'd have been massive in the States as well.
Yeah, yeah.
They'd have got on the film and all that, but they were slightly too big stars, so they refused to go on in the middle of the night, which was a mistake.
Yeah, but it's funny, like, you know, sell out the Albert Hall and the Fillmore, and
we'd better listen to it, guys. We're running out of time. Yeah. So this is You Get Brighter by the Incredible String Band. So that was the Incredible String Band.
It was that too.
And
You Get Brighter
every day.
It was a career highlight for us. We supported them a couple of times.
And right.
Supporting your heroes, that was really... Well, we supported Gotham as well, haven't we? But it's a great fun.
Yeah. What were they like when you met them?
They're really sweet. I mean, the first time we met him, well, there's the third one, Clive Palmer. We talked to him quite a lot too. But they're really friendly.
Cool. Yeah.
Banter geniuses.
Not exactly. just happy people.
Yeah, that's quite an art.
Yeah.
Well, it comes across in their music as well, you know.
Yeah.
Chilled out.
So on to the third, which is back to the live music. Mm-hmm. And I see that the first track that you are going to play is The Shoals of Herring. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
It's a song by the great Ewan McColl, who was really important person in the revival of British folk music in the 60s, I guess, 50s and 60s. And he wrote, but he was into reviving traditional music, but he also wrote some great songs. And this is one of them.
Yeah, he was a great inspiration for a lot of Irish folk artists as well. Like
his songs sound like the traditional.
Yeah,
he had a knack of just.
He could say so much in so little words.
So what's the, you know, the sound of traditional, then?
I don't really know. Actually, that's a good question. But it just.
It's like folk music is the music of the people.
This is from a series called The Radio Ballads, which was about people's jobs. It was a series that was made for BBC Radio at the time, and part of the reason why it sounds so real is that the songs and everything else is based on interviews with people who did this kind of work. So he's echoing things that people actually would say if they were talking about their work or talking about their situation. And I think that's what's folk about it, is that there's a kind of voice of the people element to it. And in the case of these songs, very, very deliberately so. That was part of the brief. But
yeah, in this song as well, like, you have the starting off as a young boy on the boat, and you see the progression up, you know, and it lifts your heart when you're out fishing and pulling in nets that you can actually get up there, you know, in time. You have to do a lot of grafting first, though.
No, it was not an easy job then or now. Yeah.
They didn't have subsidies back then, though, I think.
No. They didn't have sonar, and they didn't have...
No.
Just had to go out there and guess where the fish were.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's have a listen to The Shoals of Herring.
With our nets and gear, we're faring on the wild and wasteful ocean.
It's there on the deep that we harvest and reap our bread. As we hunt the bonny shoals of herring. Was a fine and a pleasant day. Out of Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger, for to go and hunt the shoals of herring. Work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment sure it took some bearing. There was little kindness and the kicks were many as we hunted for the shoals of herring. We fished the sward and the broken bank. I was cooking, I'd a quarter sharing, and we used to sleep standing on our feet, and we dream about the shoals of herring. And we left the home grounds in the month of June, and to canny shields we soon was faring, with 100 grand of the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals of herring. Fisherman, you can swear and show a manly bearing. Take your turn on watch with the other fellas while you're following the shoals of herring. In the stormy seas and the living gales, just to earn your daily bread, your daring. From the Dover Straits to the Faroe Islands, while you're following the shoals of herring. A million miles, caught 10 million fishes. We was following the shores of herring. Night and day we're faring. Come winter, wind. Sweating or cold, growing up, growing old and dying, as we hunt the bonny shoals of herring.
Lovely.
Yeah. That's really beautiful,
I like the way you were talking about it lifting hearts there.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. No, it captures it all, that song, really.
Yeah. Speechless, that's good. I know, yeah. We managed to leave Sarah speechless. It's brilliant.
Where's your mic, Steve? Where's your mic? Your blue mic?
I'm on it.
Ah, peace and harmony.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, yeah, just be fabulous sitting around drinking to you guys. when are you playing next? We haven't really...
Oh, Lord.
We've got some festivals. We're playing at Glastonbury. We've played Glastonbury every year for ages. It's great. And we've got... There's Once Upon a Time in the West in July around Westbury Trowbridge Way. And we're doing Ferrara again.
Buskers Festival again. Yes.
Which we've played every year for the past...
creatures of habit, 23 years or something. Yeah.
What's it like over there in Ferrara?
It's a lot of things. It's
Well, the Italian people love music.
Yeah,
for sure.
We've got a lot of friends in the city. The festival's changed a lot over the years, but we kind of almost have to go now. I think there are people we see there we don't see anywhere else.
Well, we have to go now because we've finally got a new album for them for the first time.
We have a very good friend who puts us up as well in his house, and it's just very comfortable.
Yes. So how new is this album?
Well, it took us a while to finish it, but it was only really finished
November.
Yeah,
something like that.
That's fairly fresh.
Fairly fresh.
Okay, and what's it called, and where can we get it?
You can get it via Bandcamp. That's the only thing.
Digitally distributed it then.
You can buy one. You can order it on Bandcamp, yeah. and I'll send you an actual CD. But so if you can spell Hodmadoddery and you can add Bandcamp to that and put it in Google, you'll end up in the right place.
Mm-hmm. And also at your gigs, I presume.
Yeah.
And what's it called?
It's called Hodmadod Meets Gogmagog.
All right.
Yeah. Who decided?
In a matter of fact.
And what inspired that then?
Is it a concept album?
A concept album, indeed. Gogmagog was a giant who lived in the Isles of Britain before the humans did, if you believe the medieval chroniclers. So, and it's also a range of hills near Cambridge that is famous for crop circles and hill figures. But you need to get the album to look at the pictures on it to know the hill figures I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. So it's just a weird part of England, and I'm into weird England, you know. So it's mm-hmm. a reference to that, really.
So how long did it take to record?
Far too long, but
a couple of years.
That's not bad, is it? Not working
all the time. You understand? We have some very good friends that we like to work with, but they have.
Busy lives.
They have busy lives and things that are actually making them money. So sometimes
one of them had a recording studio that was something to fit in with his.
So who's produced it then?
Ed Boyd, who right. of a fluke fame and other various right. other bands. And
great. Lisa.
He helped us record. He's wonderful. He's got a wonderful sense of what sounds right. He can tell you if something's wrong without making you feel demeaned. Bad.
Yeah,
where's
he's
that
such
studio?
A nice man. We did it in I can't remember what the name of it is. It's run and owned by Leon Hunt.
It's called the Brown Ratio. Quite why it's
Brown
called the Brown Ratio. That
sounds like
an in joke somewhere, but that I don't understand. But Leon Hunt, who's a cracking banjo player, lives in Bath.
And let us use his studio free, which was very, very kind of him.
Yeah. So if people want to find out more about this fabulous duo. You have a website, which is hodmadoddery.co.uk,
yeah.
is it?
Yeah. We have a Facebook page as well.
And it's spelled as it sounds, with an E at the end, isn't it? Yes. Airy, not Ari.
Hod, mad, and odd.
Okay, an Airy. Hod, mad, and Airy. Sorry. Oh, that's a good one. Okay, so we better keep rolling, aren't we?
Yeah,
right.
The next one I recognise.
Hey.
Battle of Evermore. Is that Led Zeppelin or did they do a cover and it's original from?
I didn't want to do this at first. I thought, we're not going to be able to do this. But then, funnily enough, we seem to be able to. So I was a little bit iffy because it's the sort of song you don't want to do badly.
It's more battles, isn't it? Mm.
Kind of, yes. The Lord of the Rings-esque.
And the original's got Sandy Denny on it, and you've got to be careful with that. Careful with that. That's holy material.
Mm.
Let's do it.
Bring it back.
Stuff.
I just really wanted to put some drum on that and really rock it up. And can you bring it to one of the Celtic sessions in Froome so we can all join in?
Well, the
sorry,
the version of that on the album has got John Joe Kelly, who was the Baran player in Fluke, who's
arguably the best.
I heard him.
Yeah, on that very track.
Yeah. Excellent. Right. Look forward to listening to that.
Yeah, I can't wait to hear that, yeah.
We haven't got much time, so John, I'm going to have to let you speak and introduce the last track.
Right, we're coming up to the last track. We're going to do Ninny Ann first.
We do. I've got a tune there.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that then, Tony.
This track, I suppose it started off because I had the music for it knocking about for some time. Used to busk it sort of as an instrumental sort of jam. And then one day Steve said, I reckon I could write some words to that, you know, give me a bit of time. And off we went, and he wrote some lovely words for it. It's the only song we've ever written. But I think it's one of the better songs we do also. It's kind of, I don't know, I think, is that about it? Any more I should say about it?
Well, hopefully not, because...
No, that's it. Let's play it instead.
Let the song do the talking.
Laughing with the winds and quaffing rain, rolling hills and running waters move through you. Sap and sunlight coursing in your veins. Old as a stone, the talismans you wear. Young as a passion being born. Stories of ages woven in your hair. Like Star Trek they run. On and on and on and on and on.
Fantastic. Thank you so, so much for coming in to play in the studio. We're massively running out of time, so I'm just going to have to say...
Because okay. We go
thank
on too
thank you
long.
As well. It's been lovely. Thank you.
Yeah, it's been great.
Okay, and just to let everyone know about our previous act, which was on the last show, Carrie Grace. She's going to be playing live in Glastonbury on May the 21st at the King Arthur with Steffi Sharp Strings, which is...
Very cool indeed.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a really great night, actually. The album's that authentic spirit of summer, you know? Festival. Okay, and on the 4th of June, we are going to be introducing Genealogy, which is jazz. So, good night, everyone. Thanks so much for listening. See you next month, and let's listen to Genealogy.
Thank you.
where's heaven? How high the moon? There is no moon above when love is far away too. Until it comes true that you love me as I love you. So where there's music, it's where you are. Somewhere there's heaven, how near, how far. The darkest night would shine if you would come see me soon. Until you